From Viking halls to the cities of the future, terrain buffs will love our foreground hub. Watch gaming tables of all genres come to life at beastofwar.com. It's time for 28mm World War II action. Will you recreate history or reshape it your way? On the Bolt Action Hub at beastofwar.com.
So, hi everybody, welcome to Let's Play The Walking Dead. I'm joined by John and Rob. Rob, of course, is from Mantic. Say hello, Rob.
Hello!
So, Rob, you're taking us through the first mission of The Walking Dead. Now, we have the bootcamp, either coming up or already out, so if you're wanting to learn to play this game, if you've got excited about it, this is the video you want to watch. So this is going to give you all the base mechanics, and basically, you know what a battle between me and John is always like. Deadly, brutal, and blood and guts flying everywhere.
Something that should last half an hour turns up being an hour and a half of us just yelling at each other.
Well, not yelling, just being snide and snarky.
Yeah, and trying to outmaneuver. So.
Yes, so if we have a look down on the tabletop, as you can see, we have our forces laid out. I'm, of course, taking out Rick, and I am taking out Carl. John, who are you taking along with you?
I am taking Patrick, Sandra, and Derek.
Okay, so the A-team versus the Z-squad.
Really?
Yeah, these are very generic survivors. These are the kind of the people that would... These are the equivalent of the red shirts in Star Trek.
Okay. Oh, man, really?
Yeah. Okay, so...
I'm disappointed now.
The way this game works is alternate activations, right? So, I'll go, John go, and if John has more characters than me, John will then go twice, yeah?
Yep, that's right.
Okay, so, let's actually just get stuck straight into the game, because I've been wanting to play this. Since we've started getting prep and stuff for the bootcamp, I've been wanting to actually get down and get a game of this. So, who gets initiative first, Rob?
Well, so in this one, it's actually you. So, normally you would get this little badge here.
All right, well, let me show that off on close camera. So you get the little Rick Grimes Sheriff's badge.
Yep.
Okay.
Well, we'll go one better than that with the special lucky hat.
Do I have to wear
the hat of initiative.
The hat of initiative. All right.
Nice, I like it.
Yeah, that suits you.
I look like an old Civil War colonel.
That's not necessarily a bad thing, right?
True. Okay, so I'll get to go first. So... The way this game works, you have a couple of actions during your activation, yeah?
Yeah, so you can do, you can like move, you can search, you can hide, and then you can also shoot. Melee doesn't count as a normal action. That kind of happens in the melee phase, which we'll get into in a bit.
All right, well, we've got our handy-dandy little ruler because this is the complete set. So I'm going to start with Rick, and I'm going to have him sneak and be very, very sneaky.
Be very sneaky.
Be very sneaky. So Rick from here, 4 inches is more than enough to take him to here. And you know what? Let's start things off with a bang. He's going to shoot this zombie.
Now remember,
remember
to explain that we have two actions per character as well.
Yes.
So that we can, but we can't do two of the same
action. No, you can't do the same action. So you've got to mix it up, basically.
Yeah, and I assume sneaking and running count as the same thing?
Yeah, that counts as moving, yeah.
Okay.
So you can't be sneaky in that sense.
All right, well, Rick is going to shoot. So for his shoot stat, he has a blue dice. And because of his gun, he gets an extra 2 red dice. So, I'll assume the opposite player would normally roll for the zombie, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
But we have you here as a games master, so I'm going to have you play the zombies.
I will play the role of the zombies, yeah.
Oh, walkers, walkers.
Yeah, oh, sorry, walkers. Yeah, walkers. Don't say the Z word.
Yes, well, that's why I said Z team.
Ah, he's very funny.
All right, well, first shot of the game.
Yep.
Let's see what we get. Ooh, hello. That'll be 4.
4, wow.
With I don't
fancy
this.
With a little exclamation mark, which means that's a headshot. I can live with that.
Okay, so I get a bonus because you're shooting slightly over cover, so I get to roll 2 red dice.
Nearly.
3. So I get 3.
Yeah. But my 4 with the headshot, I assume means boom.
Yeah, his head explodes.
Dead walker.
In gore.
Lovely.
So the only way to kill them, actually take them off straight away, is to get the headshots.
Yeah, so you can roll hits which will knock them back and knock them down, which you'll see, but with the headshot, it's just like, well, boom, headshot, dead.
Yeah.
Unfortunately for me now, because I've shot, that's a rather loud noise.
Uh-huh.
So that's going to cause some mayhem. So what's going to happen is we have a mayhem tracker here. We're actually starting it on 4 just to make the game go a little quicker. But because I cause mayhem, goes up 1 to 5. And as this goes up, depending on the actual morale of your guys, they may not activate, which is a little bit bad.
Or they may do something really silly.
Just like screaming.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Well, There was a moment earlier where Carl was amazing off camera, knocked the baseball guy back, and he just lay screaming on the ground.
And then stood up like nothing was wrong.
Yeah, yeah. Well, Carl can be scary. Yeah. If you have seen the show, Carl can be very scary. But anyway, I've shot, so the mayhem has went up, but now every single walker within 10 inches of me is going to get to move. So that one, that one, that one, and that one.
So you have four walkers coming towards you.
Four walkers who are going to shamble towards me, six inches. So this one shambles forward.
Rick is going for it in this time. I can't believe it.
Really is, yeah.
This one shambles forward, but it will go boof. This one will shamble, but go boof. And this one will shamble and also go boof. So they're all hugging that.
I thought the terminology was donk.
Is it donk?
Yeah, donk. I think the official terminology is donk.
Official terminology is donk.
Our walkers donk into things.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's Rick's activation done.
Right.
So hang on. Sorry, just one thing. You've got to make sure that your gun doesn't get jammed.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Well, let's see. Blank.
Yeah. So unfortunately it does. So that means you are now out of ammo for that one.
Oh! Blast.
And that was because you rolled a headshot. So if you just rolled a normal shot, you would have been fine. But if you roll a headshot, you've got to roll that black dice.
Yeah. Right.
And yeah, that isn't looking great for Rick.
So Rick, you have been very silly today, my friend. You have came out scrounging for supplies and brought one bullet. What's wrong with you? Yeah.
Or didn't clean the gun properly. Right? It's just not functioning at
all. It's just been messing around.
Well, that's my first activation done. Mm-hmm. So, John, it's on to your activation.
It's over to me. Right. Yeah. Do you want to hand me the measuring stick?
Yeah. And I'll put that there. I'm only going to wear that for the first because it really makes you sweat. I probably have a big red band around my head right now.
Okay, so let's have a look here. So I've Patrick used a baseball dude. Mm-hmm. And I think I'm going to... I don't know what to do. There's a lot of stuff I need to like pick up over here. So
yeah.
I think Patrick's just going to be annoyed today, and I think he's just going to get into combat with this thing, I think.
Okay.
So he's going to run, and then he's going to just push in there.
Okay. Now, running generates noise.
Yeah.
If you run into melee with a zombie, does it count as the closest zombie for a zombie activating to move toward you?
So, well, because he's already run into melee, that zombie is now ineligible. So it's basically any zombies that aren't kind of in melee and are within 10 inches. So that one's already in melee. So you might need to check for this one over here, actually.
Yeah, or this one here.
Oh, yeah, that one as well.
So yeah, that one, I think might be closer and shamble towards you.
I have a feeling it is, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, so that's going
to
start.
Flip the ruler over to the shamble side.
Yep.
That's one thing I do like, is this ruler has both sides. So
that's actually going to shuffle up.
Yeah, so they'll nudge round and they'll gang up on you now.
So that one will...
They'll actually nudge round and come in for Patrick.
Oh.
2-on-1!
That's not so good anymore.
Oh, that's going to be funny.
He's fine, he's got a baseball bat.
You're true.
Yeah.
I believe I still have a second action, right?
Yeah.
So I can roll the black dice to reduce the threat.
Yeah, so to try and keep things under some kind of control, you can roll that black dice, and if you get a shield, it lowers the threat level.
Nope.
No, you're all panicking.
Denied. Well, not so much panicking as, oh crap, there are walkers everywhere. Yeah. We're going to have to deal with this.
Stuff's coming.
All right, so back to my activation. Now it's Carl.
Mm-hmm.
So Carl is actually going to start to herd the walkers around a little bit to get them away from his dad, because this one here is very close to Rick. So what Carl's going to do, he's going to go for a run right the way over to here, which is within his movement, which should activate that and have it shamble towards him.
Mm-hmm.
And it will donk here. So I'm going to have Carl then shoot that.
Yeah.
I am not being quiet today.
Wow. You're going for it this time. Last time it was all very sneaking around, looking for things. This time you're just like gung-ho. Yeah.
So Carl gets 2 red dice, and I assume your walker gets 2 because I'm shooting over...
Yeah, just a slight bit of cover there.
Here.
Yeah.
So, 1.
No. So... It's a draw. Uh-huh. So in a draw, the survivors always count as winning. Uh-huh. So that means the walker will be pushed back an inch.
So that's about an inch there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, oh, sorry, it was over here. So the walker's here, got pushed back an inch.
Yep.
So that's fine. So that means that walker will donk again.
Yeah, they'll just keep donking into things.
So I think that's the best way just to get things started. So that's both my activations done. You still have 2 left, John?
I still have 2 left. You mind handing me the ruler?
Oh, yes.
Thank you. And... We're going to be taken Sandra, and she's going to sneak in.
Okay.
Oh, wow, this is a...
This is going to be
a proper melee.
This is going to be a melee. I'm going to enjoy this one.
Okay.
You.
Yep. So, I have no one left to activate, so you get to activate your last.
Actually, no. Before I activate her, Sandra's going to use her second to try and reduce the.
Okay.
Okay.
The issues that we're having.
Cocked
dice. We'll roll that again. Sure.
No.
Still nothing. Okay. You, on the other hand, my friend, there are no. Well, they're locked, so they're into.
Yeah. They're not going to go anywhere now.
You're quite a far ways away. You're going to sneak over to here, and you're going to take a shot.
Nice, clear shot.
Yep.
Also, I forgot, because Carl shot, that's mayhem, so that would put our threat tracker up by one.
Yep, and when I shoot, it's going to do it again.
Yeah, so currently our threat tracker is still in low threat, but it's on 7.
Mm-hmm. It goes up really quick, actually.
It does,
Well, if you decide to play it loud and nasty,
which appears to be what we're doing at the minute.
Yeah.
Okay, all right, I need to open fire. So my Mr. Derek over here with his gun has
a white shoots that.
Two white dice to shoot.
A bonus white for your gun.
Yep, so that's 2.
Yep. And I don't get a bonus this time because obviously there's the walker is in clear ground.
2?
No, nothing.
So I win.
So the walker will be pushed back 2 inches and then will fall over, just kind of rolling around.
Okay.
Moaning.
Now, is it because that he's been beaten by an additional 1 that he falls over?
Yeah, that's right. So it's kind of, they don't take damage until you actually shoot them with a headshot. Instead, they get pushed back, and then any kind of excess damage actually makes them fall over as well.
So best advice staggering. For a zombie apocalypse you will ever receive, shoot them in the head.
Everybody tells you that every time, though.
Yeah,
when there's true,
when there's a big apocalypse like that, you have to shoot them in the head.
Okay, so that is both of us have completed activating all of our stuff.
Yeah.
So what's our next phase?
So it comes onto the event phase now.
Okay.
So the first thing you do is you get this handy kill zone template out.
Okay. And just see who's where.
Yeah, so that shows you basically if there's any survivors are in a zombie's kill zone.
Safe.
They will shuffle towards them.
These are all safe and he's down.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Okay.
All fine.
So these guys are already in combat, so you don't need to move those. And next, you draw an event card.
Okay, so the event this time is Feeding Frenzy. So I assume on these cards that it's, depending on what your threat level is, tells you what to take. So currently we're on low, all quiet and low, medium and high. So we're currently in low threat.
Yeah.
So roll the black dice for each survivor engaged in melee against one or more walkers. On a Sheriff's Badge symbol, the model loses 1 health point. If there are no models in melee, add 1 to the threat level. So, you're in melee, John.
I am.
And that means you have to roll the dice.
Here we go.
For the first.
For the first.
Does take a wound.
So, is this me against the walker at this
point? So you can choose which one takes the...
Sweet, right, it'll be yellow shirt guy.
Okay.
So yellow shirt guy takes one. I then have to roll for Sandra.
Oh no, it's the survivor.
Yes,
it
takes survivor.
It's
survivor.
Survivor that takes it. Right. So.
So basically, baseball guy takes a wound.
Yeah.
Okay. So Patrick takes one.
Yeah. And then you're rolling for the other survivor.
I'm rolling for the other one.
Who does not take a wound.
Does not. That's fine. Good.
So that could have been a lot worse.
Yeah. You got away relatively lightly. Just a slight scratch.
Thankfully.
So that's the event phase done.
Yeah.
What's next?
So now it's the melee phase.
Okay.
So that's anyone who's involved in melee combat. Which
is just
you.
Me.
Yeah.
So because there's melee, the threat goes up again. So now we're on 8.
Yeah.
So like I was saying, it goes up really quick.
Yeah.
Now what you've got to do here is you've got to kind of split the combat up because you've got 2 separate groups.
Yeah.
So everyone has to be involved in melee. So basically what you'll end up with here is Patrick will end up probably taking on this walker and then Sandra will take on this walker. So they all kind of split up a bit.
Split like so.
Yeah. And then obviously if there was... Now, Rick or Carl was involved in this as well, then you would kind of split up and decide who they were going to attack.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you can decide who you want to start with.
I think Patrick's going to have to swing that baseball bat a little bit.
Okay. What are the stats?
Right, he has 1 white dice from LA plus the baseball bat, which adds a red dice.
Mm-hmm.
And if I want, because of the baseball bat, I can re-roll the red dice if I please.
Okay, that's because he's a bruiser. So there's different kind of like categories of people. So he's like a bruiser. Sandra is a runner, which means she can get over obstacles without having to roll the black dice.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's tacticians as well. And tacticians are people like Rick, obviously you'd expect. And they basically never panic. because they're super, you know, they're level-headed. They know what's going on.
There's some walkers there. We're going to deal with that. Not a problem.
Yeah. So you're playing the part of the zombie.
Yeah, so I only get one dice.
Of yellow shirt guy.
Yeah.
So here we go. Two. On to nothing. So I've won.
Yeah. So you'll push me back two, and then I will fall over.
So he's going to donk against the car and then fall over on the hood. Okay. It's fine by me.
And then your other melee.
My other melee is Sandra. Sandra isn't so good. She only has a red dice.
What you can try and do with Sandra as well, because she's got a special rule.
Nimble.
So at the start of a melee, she can roll the black dice. Mm-hmm. And if she gets a sheriff's badge, she can move 1 inch away. So it's up to you. Or you can try and take the walker out.
I'll roll the black dice and see what happens.
I assume that ability is just for free, yeah?
Yeah.
So why not?
No. So she stays in here.
So I will roll for the walker.
Which is a one.
One.
And I roll, and one. It's also one.
So that's a draw. So you still push me back, I just don't fall over.
Okay, so I go back 1 inch.
I just kind of stumble backwards, looking a bit dazed.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right, so that's round over?
That's a round over. You've just got now to see if any of the zombies that are prone, so these ones that are lying down, stand up.
Okay.
So you can roll the sheriff's dice again.
Okay, so for the yellow shirt, does not.
No.
For the person in their pyjamas, yes, does.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's all.
Yeah.
Okay.
So now the initiative hat goes to John.
I'll give you this as well, because you will not be fit to wear that for the entire show.
Challenge accepted.
Okay, so we're back to using the badge.
Okay, yep.
All right, you get to activate somebody first, John.
Yes.
So who would you like?
I think Sandra needs to start doing some work here, my runner. So.
Okay.
She's going to be very sneaky, and she's going to sneak between these two zombies with her first action and her second action, she's going to search the crate.
Okay.
Which means when I do that, I flip this over and it says search. That then comes to me and goes to her card, correct? Yes.
Yeah, you need to keep those because kind of at the end of the game, when the threat tracker reaches 18, whoever's got the most search tokens is the winner in this particular scenario.
Yeah.
So there'll be other categories of ways of winning, depending on what one you're playing. But in this one, it's just who's got the most search tokens.
If you die, you drop them.
Yes.
Yes.
Which I quite like the idea of.
So any tokens that they're carrying will go to where their base was.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have a supply deck.
Okay.
Yep.
So there you go.
I get some ammo.
Damn it.
Or an ammo reload.
Useful for someone who hasn't got any gun.
Yeah, right.
But you could pass that to someone who does have a gun.
That's right, yeah. So you can, one of your actions can be to swap items. Either that's swap items among your kind of, because you've got your head, your body, and then the item slots, so you just swap one there. Or if there's another survivor in your kill zone, you can actually swap an item with them.
Yep.
So, you know, if Derek comes over and needs some ammo,
she's got
out. Yeah.
Yep, okay. Yep. So she searched that.
Yep, so you're done.
Yeah.
So measuring
over
stick
to you.
So I'm going to activate Rick, and
make more noise, please.
No, he is going to try and get over the top of this, but I assume because he's not a runner, I have to roll the sheriff's dice. Yeah?
That's right. So on a blank, you kind of stub your toe and fall over.
Okay. Yes.
No, he's fine.
Okay.
He leaps over majestically.
Yes, and for his second action, he will also search.
All right. So
let's see what I get here. Football pads, body armor, reduced damage taken from melee attacks by one.
It's not bad.
Oh,
yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
It's not as good as Glenn's Riot gear, but that'll do.
All right.
That'll do for Rick.
Okay. Yeah, do you know what? I'm going to sneak with Derek, and he's going to search this one. So that's going to come to him. And if you could.
Yep. What have you got?
An empty cardboard box.
Nothing.
And today, your grand prize is nothing.
If this was a Metal Gear Solid game, I could hide in that box.
All right.
I have a second. No, I have used
you moved, yep.
Yep, I did. Sorry.
Okay, so now it's Carl. So I'm actually going to have Carl run, and he's going to run up and around here behind this.
He's hiding.
He's kiting.
He is making the zombie chase after him. So the zombie will move forward and donk. And he will search here, which I'm quite happy with.
Yep.
And he will receive a tire iron. Add a white dice to melee attack rolls.
Oh, wow.
That's actually really good for him because he's only got red stats on everything.
Yeah.
So giving him a white dice in melee, that's going to be good. That zombie next turn, I'm going after it.
Well, I think the zombie might come and get you actually next go, but we'll see.
All right, well, John?
Yes. Let me see. So I only have Patrick left. He hasn't activated.
Yeah.
You could sneak towards this vehicle and search it.
I think he will. You know, I see we're doing a supply grab here, so
yeah,
we're just going to have to join in on that. So he's going
to all the shooting from the first go. You've decided to play it sensible this turn.
So search. Okay. Take that to Patrick, and let's see what we've won. Bandages.
Yeah.
I can deal with that.
Yeah.
That's fine by me.
Okay, so we've moved everybody.
Yeah, yeah, that's right. So now it's the kill zone. So we kind of get the template again. Actually, do you know what? You've been very lucky there. Yeah. Look at that. Just out.
Hang on. Yeah, literally just out. Beautiful. Yeah. Rick, on the other hand, over here.
Safe.
He's okay.
Yeah.
You are not safe.
No.
No.
And over here, you are safe.
Okay.
Yep.
So this one will come in.
Into Sandra.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's fine. Actually, I wouldn't have minded that zombie coming in to Carl this time.
Yeah, you would have been fine, I think, with the tire iron. You would have been...
Yeah.
But, oh well.
So an event card now.
Yeah. Roamers. So, currently on all quiet, or no, low threat we're on. So, each player moves one eligible walker in a direction of their choice. So we're each getting to move one. John, you have initiative, so I assume you get to do this first.
Yeah, that's right. So whoever's got the initiative goes first.
Yeah.
Yep. And we need to pick carefully at this.
I assume they get to move their full shamble of six.
Yeah. So you, and if they're already in contact with a bit of terrain, so whether that's a car or a cover here, they can kind of move around. So they once they've donked, they can then move.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to be a little tactical about this.
Right.
And I'm going to shamble you. Let me see.
And that is a direction of your choice.
It is.
So it's not
in
towards...
In a straight line.
In a straight line. So that's going to shamble you to there.
Oh, so you're blocking him off.
Mm.
Okay.
So that's mine.
Okay.
We both can do this?
Yeah.
Each of us gets to do one. So...
I also did that so that I knew you wouldn't pick that one and run it towards me.
Actually, a fair point, because you can only do this...
That's right. They can only move once, yeah. Mm.
Or per walker. All right. Give me that.
I know what you're going to do. I can tell already. There's only one eligible zombie out there, that you really want to move.
Yeah, this one.
Yeah.
So it's going to shamble...
Straight towards me.
Straight up to here.
Which left me in roughly the same predicament I was in.
Yeah.
Roughly.
It's kind of actually opening up my end of the board here
a little bit, yeah.
So, melee?
Yeah. Uh-huh. So the threat goes up again.
Yeah.
Oh, now, this
we're,
is important
now we're
it's medium.
Into medium threat, and we have medium nerve characters, so this will come into play next turn.
Yeah.
So, John, actually, yes, you're the only one with a character in melee.
You could try and get away again.
I am going to try and get away again before...
Very sensible.
Yep, so here we go. No.
No.
Goodness sake.
Unfortunate.
So she has her one red.
Yeah, and I roll one for the zombie.
Okay.
Oh, dear.
Uh-oh.
Now, this is not good for you.
So you got a 2 with an exclamation mark. So what's that do?
So when it's a walker attacking, that means I have bitten you.
Oh, lovely.
I won't literally bite you.
Okay,
worry.
Thank you.
So that means on your card, you have to flip over the kind of health counter.
Yep, and that goes from a nice little heart monitor to...
Yeah, to then bitten. So you lose a wound as well, because I beat you by one.
Yep.
And now you have to roll the sheriff's dice. And on a blank, you lose another wound.
Lovely.
Yeah. Ah. No, you're fine. Just shrug it off. So you're still bitten, so you have to do that now.
Mm-hmm.
But for the minute, at least, you're all right.
But at the end of every turn now, you're going to be rolling to see if that bite gets infected.
Yeah.
So
then, and you'll get pushed away as well, because you lost, so you get pushed away an inch.
Get pushed away over here.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, then.
All right.
So we just need to see if any stand back up. So do you want to roll to see
okay,
if
so this one. Uh-huh. Stay down.
Nope, he gets up.
Ah. It's not looking good for you there.
No, that's it.
Okay, so new round.
You're keeping the hat on?
I'm keeping the hat.
Yeah, I'll take the Rick Grimes Sheriff badge to show that I am in control of this turn. So, I am going to activate Rick first, and he's just going to quite happily run up to here and search.
Mm-hmm.
Desperately seeking some extra ammo just to see what happens.
Yep.
So I get... Oh, put that on the wrong one. Damn it! I find a lurker.
Oh, dear.
So, The searching model suffers a melee attack with two red dice and may only defend. The attack is subject to the bitten rule. Increase threat level by 1 and discard this card. So, threat level is now on 10. I discard that.
Yeah.
You now roll two red dice against Rick's defense. But Rick's special rule of blood ties may kick in here. So if... Or no, it's too far away.
Mm.
If Carl is within that range of Rick, he actually gets an extra red die. So he's currently just working on his white, which is unfortunate.
Come on.
A one versus a one.
It's a draw.
So Survivor wins.
Yep.
Yes.
Oh, you're lucky.
Very.
Yes. But I always reduce damage taken by one for my my body armor now. So Rick is nigh on unkillable.
He's a beast.
He is a bit, yeah.
So, because he ran, he created noise. So which of these walkers is closest to him? So that one is... What hell if I measured the right way around?
Eight. Roughly.
Yeah.
Roughly. And this one is... over eight.
Okay.
So it'll be this one.
Mm-hmm.
It's already touching the vehicle.
Yeah, so it'll shuffle around.
Yep.
It'll shamble around to here-ish. Oh.
That's close.
Mm-hmm. So, over to me.
Yes, over to you, John.
Oh, boy. What do I do now?
Thingies and stuff and cleverness.
Yeah, that's not going to happen. Can I shift between those two?
No.
could I sneak between them?
I don't think you've got enough room, unfortunately.
If the base could have fit it, I suppose, yeah.
Which one are you
going to
activate?
You could jump over the car.
I don't know.
Because I assume the cars work the exact same as the
car.
That's
exactly,
you can jump over them.
Yeah.
You just, if you're not a runner, you have to roll for it.
Yeah.
But if I am a runner, she could just cross over that car.
She'll be fine. That's what we're saying. So you could make a daring escape.
Could I run with that? Can I run and cross the car as a runner?
Yeah, as long as it's in your normal movement, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, go for it.
What about intervening models? Like,
well, you're just going to move around them and then...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can't pass through them, but obviously you've got enough room to move around there.
Yeah.
So if I moved around them, would get her to about there?
I wouldn't be going that close to another zombie.
she's already bitten.
All right.
The rage is setting in. I think maybe she's... the virus is taking
hold. Oh, wait, hang on a minute. We're in medium threat now, aren't we?
Oh, yeah, so I was going to say, you should have rolled...
Her nerve is medium, so hang on a minute. Let's just bring her back.
Yeah.
Okay.
And let's roll this dice. Oh, dear.
No, that's good.
I know.
Yeah.
So you're getting both actions, and you're getting a bonus red in melee, is it?
So on this yellow dice, there's all different kind of actions. And basically, this is like the panic dice that you have to roll. So a question mark is terrified. Mm-hmm. So that means you can only do one action. And then there's things like scream, where you just start screaming and crying and weeping. It's probably what I would do in this situation, to be honest with you. But then you've obviously got this one, which gives you an extra dice in combat, and you could do two actions as normal.
Yeah.
So you were right, the blood rage was kicking.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. She's getting mad.
Well, if you want to redo your move to wherever you want now, because your tactics will have changed because of that.
Yeah, I'm actually going to... I'm going to get her to run around this one.
Yeah.
And take her to there.
Okay.
Okay.
With her second action, she'll search it. She may die, but you never know.
Fine. She's got it. Mm. Oh. And you've got a gun.
Oh, she's a gun now. Sweet.
So
I'll just shift all that down and equip that.
Yeah.
She now has ammo for it too. Sweet.
Yes. I actually kind of need to get to her, kill her, and steal it.
Yeah, you need to steal everything she's carrying at the minute, don't you?
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much.
Right, that's her actions done.
Yeah. Right.
Back to you.
Okay, give me the stick.
So you've got Carl, yeah? So you'll have to do the same with Carl, because he's on medium nerve as well.
Yeah, so... That.
Oh, he does the same.
Yeah.
Yes.
So two actions and an extra dice and melee.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, what Carl's actually going to do is he's going to run. And let's see. So he'll run, take him 2 inches to get to here. And then the rest of his run... let's go to there. And he will search this.
Actually, I realised what we didn't do. Sorry, we didn't move these guys in from her running and
making
noise.
Ah, yeah.
So it'll probably be that one.
Yep.
Unfortunately.
That's fine.
That's fine. So he'll be out in melee with her.
So Carl has searched here. I'll get that in a second. I think this walker would be the closest.
Yeah, I think that looks closer.
So, donk.
Yeah.
Which is fine, but that'll put him into melee this turn, which I'm okay with.
Yeah.
And then for the supplies.
Another lurker?
No. Booby trap. The searching model suffers a ranged attack with a white and a red dice and the blast keyword. Then discard this item. Who the hell booby traps a car?
Okay, so no.
So I assume I have to roll on my defense.
Yeah.
Which is a red die.
Okay. Let's see what happens.
It's gonna hurt. Blank.
So two.
So 2 points of damage.
Oh dear.
One and two. Halfway dead. As you can see here. Dun dun. Damn it. Ow!
Yeah, that wasn't great for Carl. His lucky hat didn't do him much good there.
Nope.
No, really didn't. All right, but so that's at least four search tokens on my side are now count at four, which I'm quite content with. I think, John, you can equal me, but not beat me at the minute. So we are going to have a bit of a human fight going on.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to get interesting now, I think.
Yep, yep.
That's the point, really. Kind of the walkers are kind of almost in the background. They're kind of like movable scenery that bites.
Yeah.
But now you've kind of got to get stuck in and actually kind of fight each other.
Mm-hmm. Quick question. Next time I activate Rick, can he run up to Carl and actually grab something out of his hand?
Yes, you can. Well, it would have to be the other way around, so Carl would have to go and give something to Rick.
That's fine.
So you could give him a gun, I guess.
Well, no, I'm thinking of giving him a tire iron and making Rick a melee monster. Oh
my. Yeah, that would be horrendous.
Yeah. I don't like this.
So I've activated both of mine.
Yep.
Do you have anything left to activate, John?
I still have Patrick to activate.
You've activated this?
Did he search this turn? He searched this turn, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's just Patrick you have left.
Yeah, so Patrick's left.
Or no, you have two left. I went first.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
I've activated Rick, then you activated one, then I activated Carl, so you have...
All right, so I have two left.
This one and this one left.
Okay. So Patrick and Derek still have to do some awesome things.
Yes. See, this is where the advantage of having more people comes into play, because you could actually start to try and lower the threat right now, John.
If I really wanted to.
If you wanted to. What's the nerve on all of your people?
Well, Patrick's medium, Sandra's medium, Derek's high.
Mm. Yeah.
So he's still
tough. Yeah.
He's still okay for now, I think. Yeah, he's still okay for now.
Patrick,
I think, may need to go and try and help save Sandra.
Okay.
Possibly.
Yeah.
So he needs to roll a dice.
Okay.
And hope for the berserker.
He's going to scream.
He is, isn't he? No? What's this?
No. So he can only flee. So he runs in a straight line 8 inches away from the nearest enemy.
Pair of little legs.
Fantastic.
Run away.
Fantastic. You're useless, man. All right, so his nearest one is here.
Yeah, so he'll run around the car.
He has to run around the car.
Yeah.
Was it 8 inches?
Yeah.
Oh, dear. He's put himself out of this fight, you know. So he's going to go in the car and...
Yeah, he'll stop there.
He'll stop at the edge of the table.
Yeah. So that was that moment of, nope.
Had enough of this.
He saw what was going on, thought, I didn't want to be a part of this. I'm legging it.
Yeah.
I didn't sign up for this.
Now, does he only get to do that action and nothing else?
That's it. Yeah, that's it. He just runs off.
Okay. I just wanted to see if he could try and lower that threat, because I just seen, John, how important it might be to actually get that lowered.
Yeah. Okay. Sandra's in trouble. Derek still needs to do something. Mm. What could Derek do to annoy you?
Annoy me?
Yes.
Nada. I'm sitting pretty.
Yeah, because you're on the wrong side, really. All you're really going to do, if you make a noise, you would lead them away from Carl, which you don't want to do.
Yeah.
I'm going to sneak.
If in doubt.
I'm going to sneak.
If in doubt, sneak away.
I'm going to keep quiet and sneak away, and he's going to get in behind that barrier.
Okay.
He's meant to be the tough guy. Not hiding behind barriers. He should be there shooting, going gung-ho.
He's seeing two of the A-list characters running around being awesome.
Yeah.
He's sneaking away because it's leaving these being closer to those two anyway. Mm. So.
All right, so we've moved everything.
Yes.
He could try and lower the threat if you want to do that, because he's got one action left.
I will try.
All right, see what you get.
And he does?
Yes. Yep. So he lowers it by one.
So currently our threat's at 10, so it'll go down to 9.
Still in
medium.
Yeah.
Which is unfortunate, but such is life.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now we do the kill zones. So do you want to measure for these guys?
Yep, so kill zones. This one is in range of Carl, and we'll move in. This one, definitely in range of Rick.
Yep.
And we'll move in. Not in range of anyone.
No.
Not in range of anyone. Nope. So, that'll be it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so.
Oh, event.
Yes. The hunger. So, we're currently at medium threat. Each player rolls a blue dice and moves that many eligible walkers towards the nearest survivor. So, blue dice.
And it also increases the threat as well. In the corner. So it's back up to 10.
Yeah, it's back to 10.
Mm-hmm.
So, probably a good job you did that, just to try and sort of keep everybody doing what they're doing.
Yeah.
So, I'll roll first, because I have the active turn. Just the one. What could be annoying for you?
I've seen something that could be very annoying. Do you want me to be on the side of the walkers and help?
Tell you what. If it comes up as the sheriff's badge, you don't.
Okay.
Blank, you do.
Fine,
fair enough, John?
Okay.
Blank. So what is it?
Well, this eligible walker can move in and gang up on Sandra.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll
do that. And then we'll see how deadly they are when they all gang up together.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we'll do that. Yeah. So, John, you get to now do the same.
Uh-huh.
Roll blue dice.
One again.
Mm-hmm.
There's only one walker I can really move anywhere closer to anybody.
This one?
Which is pretty much that one. So.
Yeah.
It's only going to dunk into the car, to be honest.
Well, it's actually touching the car, so it would move around the car.
Ah, okay.
Just wouldn't quite get to Carl, unfortunately.
So it would be like there.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's okay, though.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It puts Carl in the worst position for next turn.
Yep.
Of course, Carl's running around with a tire iron right now.
Rick is going to clean house over here, though.
You'd hope.
Well, I would hope. I was wanting to actually get Carl into base with Rick, pass him the tire iron, and that would leave him running around with two white dice for melee and ignoring his first wound every turn.
Yeah, you need to start shooting.
Right? God of battle.
Yeah.
Yeah, his gun's dry. Hell with that.
Yeah,
Go old school.
Mm-hmm.
So, event is done.
Yep.
We're now on to melee.
Melee, and because people are in melee, the threat goes up again.
Yeah.
To 11 now.
Yeah. If we hit 18, game over.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I have the active turn, so I'll start with Rick, who's got a white die for melee versus a zombie's red die.
Okay.
So I get one.
I get one. So it's a draw.
I push you back in it.
Yep.
John, do you want to do the one here?
Sandra is so dead.
Okay.
So,
so normally I get one, but because there's two of them, that adds extra dice, so I get three now. And if there was another one, I'd actually get another three dice. So I think earlier on I rolled six against Rick, which didn't go great for Rick.
That's pretty crazy.
Yeah.
So what's your melee, John?
Okay, not great. One red dice. But she did roll the extra...
Yes.
She rolled for bloodthirsty. Yep.
Yeah. Actually, you could roll to see if you... You might escape, actually, if you roll the black dice.
Good point. Okay. Right, let's try that.
You do.
Okay.
Oh. So I didn't get to use all my great red dice there.
One inch away. Nope. Run away.
Okay.
Then. Next up is Carl, who is getting a bonus die. He's got his tire iron.
Yep.
And he's got a single red to begin with. So
this is going to be a super tough walk. Nothing.
This should be death. Three.
Okay. So not actually dead, just pushed away.
And knocked down.
Yes, it'll probably fall into that car.
So there. I think. Okay.
So not quite as spectacular as it could have been.
God damn it, Carl!
That's all the melee then.
That was all there was for melee, so...
Black dice to see if that one stands back up.
Yep.
So you can...
Okay.
Nope, it
does not.
Dizzy.
Yeah.
After being slapped around the head with a tire iron.
Yep.
Okay, so you have the active turn, John.
Mm-hmm.
Who do you want to activate first?
I think it's going to be Patrick.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Patrick needs to roll a dice.
Yeah, that's it.
Panic dice.
He can do one action.
Yeah, so he's terrified, so he can only do one action. Yeah.
But you could start trying to drag that that threat down.
No.
Okay.
I'm running into this one.
Okay.
He's terrified.
Going for glorious battle.
He's terrified, yeah. But he's still going to do it.
You could, well, because I kind of went against you last turn, you could maybe just move next to that supply counter. So next turn, if you only get one action again.
Good point. Yeah, well, we'll do that then. Okay.
There we go. So we're on even Stevens now. I've helped everyone.
Yeah, Wow. Okay. So it's on to my activation. So I'll activate Carl. So I will have to roll.
There you go.
And see what I get.
Scream. He's got to scream.
He has to scream.
Don't scream.
He's
don't
a little boy. He's going to scream.
Don't scream. No, he gets one action. So he's going to move around to here beside his dad. But he can't give him the tire iron. He's standing there going, Dad, look what I found.
Yeah.
Look it.
That's very good, Carl. I'm a little busy.
Well, such is life. Mm-hmm. But, actually, I need to check how far I moved. Because I may have run
Ran. Inadvertently, just in his excitement to show him the tire iron.
Yeah, I did. Is it all right if I move back to sneak range?
No, You've run.
Play fair.
You've run. I am playing fair.
Roll the black dice again. This is a great way to decide any disputes. No.
Okay.
So, to there.
Yeah.
I like how he's really trying to measure the millimeters here. To make sure you're on
millimeters
that
on an inch measured stick. Great plan. Anyway, here you go.
All right.
Do your next bout of awesome.
Well, let's hope so anyway. Right. Sandra is going to run.
Uh-huh.
Well, she's going to try and
hopefully
run.
Hopefully she'll...
So one action.
You can only do one action and it can't make a noise. So you can't run, you'll have to sneak.
I have to sneak.
Or you could lower the threat level want to try and get away.
Do you know what? She's going to sneak. She's going to sneak this way. So she's going to...
Oh, you might be quite clever there because they might donk against that car.
Yeah. Let's hope anyway.
Okay.
Okay, you've activated only Carl so far, so it's over to you.
So I've got Rick. Rick is going to sneak. And he's going to sneak this way.
He's just leaving Carl behind.
Bye, Carl. That was shiny. I know you wanted to give it to me, but no. It would have been nice. Sorry, son. And for a second action, he actually will try and reduce the threat.
Okay.
So, where is Black Dice? Because I think I could do with... No.
Could do with nothing.
No. Damn it!
Yeah.
Damn it, Carl!
You get nothing.
Okay.
You lose! Good day, sir!
You get nothing!
Thank you, Mr. Wilder.
Yes. Right. Yes. Thank you, Mr. Wilder.
So, back to Derek, then, who's my last guy.
What's he going to do? Because you can't just sneak about here now.
I really wish he could get into a position that if he made a noise, it would just take everything to you. But
yeah, that's your big problem at the minute. He has a ranged weapon, but he can't use it. Because if he does, everything within 10 is just going to go...
He's got to throw his voice. So it sounds like it's coming from the cars over there, and they all move towards
I didn't
that.
Know Jeff Dunham was in this show.
All right, well, he's going to continue to sneak then. So he's going to sneak in behind this barrier.
Okay.
His second... action is going to be threat reduction, I think.
Okay.
Nope.
No.
Everybody, calm down!
It's getting tense. Okay, so...
So now we do the kill zones?
Yep. So, kill zone over here is in.
Carl's in trouble.
No, he's not. He's got a tire iron.
Yeah, he's fine.
Over here.
Patrick, he's baseball got a wielder. Baseball bat.
Yep.
He should be fine.
Yep. Over here... You're fine.
Right.
Those two are having a chat.
And these two are just, arguing about weather. Just because there's nothing else to do.
Yep.
Okay.
So you want to draw an event card?
Yep. There's a storm a-coming. So, low, medium, and high threat. The tension reaches fever pitch. Add +1 to the threat meter to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
Add another level immediately. Draw 2 more event cards, applying the results one at a time.
Okay, this could be bad.
This could be very bad.
So, next up, won't stay down. We're currently on medium threat. So, as low threat, in addition to each player's rolls... Oh, right, so I have to do low and medium.
Yeah.
Okay, For each prone walker, roll the sheriff's dice. On a star, the walker gets up. If there are no prone walkers, add +1 to the threat level. Oh, there is
look
one.
Look at this one there, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So if you want to roll John for this one, doesn't get up. That's fine. Each player rolls a blue dice and moves that many eligible walkers in a direction of their choice. So you're the active player, John, so after you. Don't do bad stuff.
Two.
Don't do bad stuff.
This is your chance to send them the other way.
Don't do bad stuff.
So I can move them at shambling any way I want.
Yes.
Sweet.
They're just going in a straight line unless they're in connection with terrain.
Okay.
Not Carl.
Yes, Carl.
Not Carl.
Yes, Carl.
Unfortunately, they're just out of.
You would dunk.
Yeah, I'll dunk. I want rid of Carl. Because Carl has stuff.
Yeah, that'll definitely go in base to base.
Save me! Oh, that was evil.
Yeah,
that was such an evil laugh. Alright, my turn.
Yep.
Damn you. Swine. I get to do two.
Yeah.
So, give me the mech. Stick.
Mm-hmm. So they can just walk over other walkers, prone walkers.
No.
I was going to send them.
I'm like, no. Okay, this one is going to shamble up this way.
I can deal with that.
To here.
Yeah.
Yep.
And is there any others who are eligible? No. Blast. Damn you and your having activations. Okay, we have another one of these to do.
Wow, that was just the first one.
Yeah, that was the first one.
The herd.
Oh, this sounds ominous.
Medium and high threat. In addition, all prone... so it's low and high again.
Uh-huh.
The player with initiative chooses a walker and moves it in a direction of their choice. All eligible walkers within 8 of the chosen walker also move converging on the chosen walker. There are no eligible ones?
There's just... Well, that's already moved, so that means you're going to have to bring a new walker on.
Yeah.
Because if there's no eligible walkers, you actually bring more on.
Yeah, so you get to bring a new walker on from any table edge.
Mm-hmm. Just the one?
Yeah.
The one?
Sweet. From any table edge, and then it shambles on?
As above, in addition, all prone walkers immediately stand up.
Oh.
So actually, what would happen is this would stand up.
And then could move?
And then that will be the one you're moving.
Yeah.
So do you want to do it, John?
Yep.
So that moves into Carl. Any other walker within range moves in. So Carl now has 4 walkers.
We haven't got enough red dice.
Standing around him. It's all right, we'll do multiple rolls. Melee? Anyone?
I am so happy.
And the threat level goes up again as well. To 14 now. So we're in the high threat.
Yeah. Oh, this is going to suck.
You have 2/3 of the walkers on the table on one of your own characters.
Yeah, Carl is going to be running to hell next turn if he survives.
You think he's going to
survive? This is you were boasting about, the tie iron.
He's got his lucky hat. He has his lucky hat. Mm. He could survive on 0 wounds. So...
Unless he's bit.
Does that affect it, if he's bitten?
If he dies... Then he still gets a roll, but then he'll get bitten and probably die again. So you'll just keep repeating and dying.
Anyway, let's do the boring combat first. So over here is a combat with you, John.
Yes.
So if you want to do that with your baseball guy, Patrick.
Okay. You call this boring. So
things are about to get pretty interesting.
Yeah. Fair enough. Okay, so
I got 1.
You got 1. I got 3.
So splat. You've knocked his head clean off.
Headshot.
Yep. Nice.
Okay.
Cool.
Now, the interesting one. Mm-hmm. So, I get 1 red and 1 white to fight.
Yeah.
You get how many reds?
Well, I get a maximum up to 5, actually. So,
okay.
You've got away relatively lightly there, actually, I think.
I don't know. There's still a lot of walkers around here. So, I'll roll. That'll be 2.
2. Okay.
Not awful.
Oh, wow. Look at this.
Look at this. 4. 5 wounds. Ouch!
So you've done 2. So actually, it's just... Yeah, so it's 3.
3 wounds, but that's more than enough to take him down to 0 and be on his lucky hat roll.
Yeah.
So...
Whoa. Come on. You should wear the hat, really, for this.
No.
I tried.
Ah!
Nothing.
Dead. Wah, wah.
And so what happens now is he actually comes back as a walker.
Yeah, let's... Let's just grab a random walker to put in here.
There you go.
But that one, that used to be Carl.
Carl's grown a bit.
In death. All right, the other thing I need to do is put his search template or tokens down under that walker. Because they're all there now, all on the ground.
Let's take
the hat's gone, the tire iron's gone, the 22 revolver's gone. It's a horrible day. Rick, why did you leave your son? You're a horrible parent.
So,
yeah,
I guess...
New round.
Yeah. I'm quite happy with this.
Yeah, I think...
I'm pleased with myself. At least I haven't died yet.
So there's no walkers to stand up. Okay. So.
Right.
You have made Rick into a badass, though. He could storm his way in there and take that stuff.
No, he's not. Not going to risk that. He's going after you people.
That's fine.
So, I have the initiative, means Rick goes first.
Yep.
So, stick.
There you go.
Rick doesn't care about threat levels.
He's just gone crazy now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you killed my son! So, he's going to run. To here.
Okay.
And he's going to search.
Can he search when he's got into base to base?
No.
Oh. Well,
I thought you were running in to shoot him, so that's all right.
No, because my gun's out of ammo.
Oh, yes, of course. Yeah.
He's just run into melee then. Which should do just nicely if I can take out Patrick in melee.
Mm-hmm.
We'll
so,
see.
My activation then?
Activations, you now get to activate everybody.
Oh, yeah, I get to do everything now. Okay.
So I'm going to put Carl.
You need to make sure closest walkers start moving towards you
because
of
the run. Oh, yes, because I run.
Yeah.
So it's within 10 inches, isn't it?
Yeah. So you might be...
So, yeah, I was out.
Yeah, you've actually ran away from it. So
yeah,
cool.
So there's no walkers nearby.
They just all stood there having a little party.
Having a mill around while we try and decide the fate of humanity. So
well, I don't know. Carl is...
Oh, so you need to roll
Carl's
the...
Carl's still lunch.
Oh, oh yes. I still need to do this, so... Sandra.
Yeah?
You're still there.
Yeah. Do stuffs.
So she can do one action.
She can do one action, okay.
So you could move into melee as well.
She could, but she's a lot closer to walkers than you were. It doesn't matter.
Yeah,
we've decided it doesn't matter.
You're all gonna have to gang up. It's getting towards the end of the game. You need to take out Rick.
She's running in there.
Yeah,
and Derek.
Now he's although he's high. Obviously now the threat level is at high, so he's gonna roll too.
Yep.
Rick's just a badass who doesn't.
He's gonna do one action too.
Yeah, I wished he had screamed.
I know, right? That would have been quite funny.
Although, why is everybody leaving me alone?
Does he do? Does he sneak? Does he make a noise? Does he...
You've got a couple of turns to get him to Rick.
He could take a shot.
Well, you could take a shot. Yeah,
could take a shot.
Take a shot. Take a shot. Go on. Take a shot.
I'm not going to take a shot. I'm not taking a shot. I'm sneaking.
Yeah.
I'm never doing anything Justin suggests. We're sneaking.
Okay.
So that's... Well, we're on to melee now, clearly.
No, we're
still
on
got
to...
The events.
Yeah.
And actually, because there was a melee last turn, the threat should have went up another one.
Not that turn, no. So it was stayed.
But
it was
Carl was in melee?
I think we put it up for Carl.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so it's just an event then?
Mm-hmm. You just want to get to the end of the game.
The hunger. Okay. So, the walkers suddenly stop. Nothing else happens. That's all quiet. Low threat. Each player moves one eligible walker towards the nearest survivor.
Okay, well, we're on high threat, so what's it say for...
Then it says each player rolls and then moves any eligible... right, so we're starting with the medium threat and then doing the high threat as well, okay? So each player rolls a blue dice and moves that many eligible walkers toward the nearest survivor. As medium threat, in addition, all prone walkers immediately stand up. There are no prone walkers, so we're both just rolling the blue die and seeing how many walkers we're moving.
That does actually put the threat up by one automatically.
It does as well, so... Things are getting hairy. So I get to move one.
You move one. I wonder which one you're moving.
Huh. Well, I wonder. Give me that. Unfortunately, it will donk.
Yep. Yeah.
It's a donker.
All right, you get to roll and move however many. Don't get three. He got three.
Ooh. Oof. Everything's going to donk against the car. Probably.
So.
Okay, so... You're just going to...
Are you going to send Carl after his dad?
Yes. Why wouldn't I do that?
Because it's evil.
So you're coming to about there and donking. And three.
Here comes Carl.
Here comes Carl, who's going to donk as well there.
Here he comes to wreck the day.
To wreck the day.
Well played.
Yeah. Sorry.
Okay, and now it's melee. Mm-hmm. So because we're in melee with other survivors, still goes up. So yep. We're on, what, 15 now?
Yep.
I think.
Yep.
I think it's 15. We're saying it's 15. That'll do.
Okay. Well, you're the one with the initiative.
Yep. So Rick has a melee of a white die.
Mm-hmm.
So you combine all your rolls for yours. So.
Yeah. All right, so I'll be working on this. So.
Oh, damn. I should have been using Stay Calm.
Oh.
Rick's ability, it automatically happens, and he can just roll a blue dice and reduce it by that many. I'll have to remember that for a future game.
We could have been here all day, though, if you'd done that.
Yeah, exactly.
Rick would have been calming everyone down.
Okay, chilling everyone out. All right, so Rick gets his white dice. Now, how does this work whenever John has two survivors in melee with me?
So he will combine. Yeah, he will combine the melee.
Okay.
And if there was another zombie in here, then he would combine that as well.
Mm-hmm. So. Okay. So, just the one.
One. Okay. So when I'm combining my attacks, is it just their bases? I don't get bonuses for
them? So you'll get your baseball bat bonus. Yep. So you'll get white and red, and then you'll get the red from Sandra. Yep.
Okay.
And you get to reroll one red.
Yeah.
Yes.
This may have been a bad plan.
There we go.
Three
to one.
But because of my body armor, I only take one wound.
Oh.
Mm. So you take two.
No. So, I got one.
Yeah.
You got three.
Yep.
That three becomes a two. Mm-hmm. Body armor makes it a one.
Okay.
Yep.
That's fine.
So Rick is tough.
And then you, because Rick lost, he gets pushed away an inch.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so Rick will bounce back an inch to here. Mm-hmm. With walkers just coming up the side of the table here.
Yep.
To munch on everybody as they're having a bit of a scuffle.
Yeah.
Okay, that is...
So that's the end of that. So there's no prone walkers, so nope. It's on to the next round.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so John, you get to go first.
I do. And
one of your characters there has a gun.
Yeah.
Right next to Rick.
You just want him to make noise.
No. I'm trying to be helpful.
All right, well, I'm activating Patrick.
Okay.
He's immediately going to search this.
Whoa, hang on. You have to roll your...
Right.
No,
he flees.
he runs away again. Patrick.
This stranger in football armor is scaring me. I'm going to run.
So he has to run away directly away from...
Directly away from...
Yeah. From the walker? Or
no, from the nearest enemy. So... Rick counts as an enemy.
Ah, okay. So
full run.
It's there.
And are there any walkers within 10?
I doubt it.
Yeah.
Oh, there is.
So this one will shamble just up along the edge of the car. Getting closer to Rick.
Yes. So his 6 inches is about... Oh, yeah, he actually shambles up to Rick.
Ah, but don't forget, he'll dunk this first.
Yeah.
He's on the side of the car, though.
Yes, but he'll dunk this next
barrier. Dunk the other barrier.
Yep. Dunk.
Dunk.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, because of that, there's only one thing Rick's going to do here.
Make noise.
No, he's going to just sneak into combat here. Because now you're fighting alone, and I should be fit to kill you a little bit easier.
Possibly.
Well, Patrick is gone. Mm-hmm. You now can't walk away from combat.
Yeah.
So I should have a fair shot at it.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay. So, my activation then?
Yes. Well, your last activations.
Same. Yep.
So, for who?
It can only be
Derek,
because you've got into melee with her, so.
Run away.
He also flees. From the nearest enemy. So, that's there. So, he's now running.
Yeah. Turn it around.
I don't think Derek's done much this game, really. Derek has been fairly useless.
Yep. So he's now back in the table corner.
Mm-hmm.
He's meant to be the leader.
Yeah.
He's just been running around.
Yeah, it's not been so good this time.
Okay, so we've all moved people.
Yep.
Yep.
Event.
So the kill zone first.
Oh, yes.
So I think, unfortunately for you...
The walker's going in.
To Sandra, yeah.
Yep.
Nice. Right. And no other kill zones matter.
No.
So now an event.
Mm-hmm.
Pandemonium! So, threat will go up by another one to 16. Let's see. High threat. Players move all eligible walkers in a direction of their choice. Then two rolls of the blue dice of walkers enter play.
Okay. Oh, dear. Wow. That's a lot.
Yeah.
We're doomed.
I'm just wanting you to double check. Make sure we don't have to do the medium as well.
No, so you just go straight to high threat. So players move all eligible walkers in a direction of their choice.
Okay.
Then two blue walkers. So what you do is you start with the person who has the initiative. So that was you. And then you alternate. Or was it you?
It was John.
Okay, I have the initiative.
Yeah, so you will start and then it'll be Justin's turn.
Move a walker wherever you like.
Okay. And they'll just all shambly shamble.
Yes. Shambala.
They will shambly shamble their shambling selves.
To go donk?
To go donk on the car at 6 inches.
Yeah. My turn.
Mm-hmm.
I will shambly shambly, just so I don't donk the car up to here.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
This is going to be interesting.
Yeah. So these two have moved.
Yeah.
These three still have to go.
This one's going to work its way down and donk into the the barrier again.
Yeah. Things are getting a little bit hairy.
Yep.
This one is going to shamble in a straight line up to here. Do they stop if they hit other walkers?
Yeah, once they go through a walker, they will stop.
They bump into each other.
That'll stop there.
Okay, and then we have the last one here.
Yeah, which is for you to do.
Mm-hmm.
So where to? Straight to the car?
Yeah, pretty much.
Donk.
And then you roll to see how you roll that twice, actually, see how many more come on.
I roll it twice.
Yeah. So that's two.
And four.
Four.
So they can start on any board edge.
John that deploys all four?
You'll alternate again.
Okay.
So and they can't start in the kill zone of another survivor. So unfortunately, you can't just put them all right near Rick. Not that I'm suggesting you do that.
No, of course. Can I check with the kill zone thing? So if I hold that over Rick.
Yeah.
Well, I can put one there.
Okay. If you can hold the kill zone over Derek, down the back here, I'll put one here. Dun, dun, dun!
Okay, so, and then number three
is
there.
Okay. And number four, if you hold the kill zone again.
Oh, look at that, he's surrounded.
I thought that was just an evil thing to do.
Actually, no, we'll have to move him because it should be on a table edge, so it should be there.
Okay.
So.
Melee.
I don't think anybody's going to win this game.
So I get Rick's white die.
Oh, so that goes up as well. So we're nearly to the end. So we're on 17 out of 18 now.
Yep. So a white die, and I get a red die for the Zom.
You could try and
I will.
Run away first.
I will be trying to run away.
Don't.
That'd be great.
Yes!
Okay, so I bump an inch away, don't I?
Yeah,
you just move an inch away, directly away.
So,
Damn you and your sneaky slyness.
That's well done. That's well played.
Yeah, so fresh round.
We should move over to you.
So. Okay, Rick's going to activate.
Is Rick going to do something silly?
He's going to do something clever.
Uh-huh.
So, Rick will activate.
So just remember that it will end immediately once it gets to 18. So.
Oh, I know. He will... Well, actually, if it's ending immediately, he'll sneak here.
Yep.
And he'll make noise.
Okay.
Just as an action. Now, is the make noise only attracts one zombie?
Yeah, just, yeah.
Oh, I see what you're doing.
That is very clever.
Mm-hmm. Very nicely done.
What am I doing?
Well, I think you're making noise and then going to move that. Walker.
Yeah, yellow shirt bumps into Sandra.
Yeah.
And then that's one last person that you can activate.
This is true.
While Rick is hiding behind a car going, I'm safe.
So that's a good way to use the walkers to your advantage there. And that's kind of what you can do as well, particularly when there's loads of walkers on the table, you can actually.
Now John gets to activate everything of his.
Okay, so Patrick, rest his soul, is going to try and do something. So move
quiet
makes
actions.
One action.
Quiet make action. A noise.
Oh dear, that's a shame. Because I'm gonna.
What does he do? Does he go and help Sandra? Does he attack
Does he finish Rick?
Does he try? Well, finish Rick is a bit optimistic considering that he's pretty tough, so I don't think I can do that. He's going to sneak up to here.
Okay, so up to that last set of stuff.
Yep, and then Derek.
Yeah.
Come on, Derek.
Do something, mate.
I want to see him do something great.
I really do want to see him do something great. But he also has to roll.
Oh, so, yeah?
Yeah.
He screamed.
Oh, Derek.
Worst time.
One of the zombies moves in.
One of or all of?
Just the one, yeah, because he makes a noise, so, yeah.
Ah. Pick one of the two and send it in.
There we go. It's getting there.
Okay.
Awesome. So,
it's then kill zones.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, zombie kill zones. Is in?
Yeah.
Yep.
So, shamble in there.
Yep.
And then just out.
Just out.
Yep.
Oh, you should have put Patrick in to help.
It's just out.
I think just, yeah.
Everything else is out, so that's fine. So, because we're in melee.
Oh, event first.
Oh, event first, okay.
Yeah.
Alarm. All threat levels. The player with the initiative chooses a car other than a resource hub. If there are no cars in play, if possible, it must be one that no survivor is within six of. So this is basically a car alarm's going off and dragging all the zombies away. The problem I have now is we're about to up the threat level to 18. Do we still do the combat for this round, or does it automatically?
No, ultimately it stops once it reaches 18.
So
that's it.
We're in melee, it goes to 18, and game over, right?
Yeah.
So, it's down to resources.
Mm-hmm.
So, John, how many do you have?
I have four.
I have two.
So, winner. John is the winner.
Well played. Oh. I had you worried there.
You did, but no.
Well, that was really fun to get to play through again, and I'm really looking forward to whenever we get an entire weekend's worth of this, where we're just sitting down, having some zombie fun, hearing people just moaning through the gaming hall.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to make a survivor costume and walk around in tattered-looking clothing. So.
Yeah. Well, guys, that'll do it for us. Hopefully you've enjoyed that battle report on The Walking Dead. Drop your comments below. Have you played it yourself? Are you looking forward to getting to play it? We'll move on here. We'll see you in another video.
Progress comes to a world of magic as science and the arcane combine to make marvels. Meet steampunk inventors and orc mystics at the Volsung Hub on beastsofwar.com. Anime cyberpunk style meets skirmish combat in Infinity. Experience 8 high-tech factions and fight to control the human sphere at the Infinity Hub on beastsofwar.com.